west side, just north of Campbell Island. July 24, time is 11:08, flying at 500 feet and approximately 50 miles per hour. We'll be speeding up to about 65. Two still shots taken on this barrier complex, resulting from sediment transport up the bay toward the southwest. Shots numbers 10 and 11 on color film number one. It's a sandy beach with a small gravel component and some mud in the back shore. Cliffs approximately 8 meters high, sands and gravels, partially stabilized. Picking up some retrogressive thaw failures here with massive ice in the head walls, intermittent mud flow transport down across the beach, and it's been truncated by wave processes. Have been stabilized and then cliffs developed again in the old stabilized failures. It's quickly sand in the cliffs here in some places, but there is a gravel component at the beach. And is it in the lower foreshore here, sand in the back shore, pebbly sand material in the cliffs. Old retrogressive thaw failures all along here. They've been gullied. Sandy gravel aprons, the gravelly sand aprons in the back shore. A small little fringing barrier in places here. Relatively wide intertidal zone, up to 5 to 10 meters wide. We're just coming up to the point opposite turnabout point. All along here we have these complex fringing barriers. Thick complexes. Picking up the beginning of one here, recurved spit at the downdrift end. Shallow lagoons, almost partially dried at low tide in the back shore, backed by stabilized banks and stabilized retrogressive thaw failures. Some gravel in the lower foreshore and on the crest of the barrier here. A wide intertidal sandy surface fronting that active retrogressive thaw failure at the point. Coming now into cliff zone with lower apparent ice content, but there is some evidence of massive ice in a few fresh scars. Again, picking up a wide swash bar here, essentially the downdrift end of a poorly developed spit complex. Still some massive ice in the cliffs in the back shore. Beach is sand and gravel. Gravel forming a thin lag surface in the intertidal and back shore in some places. Still trying to get the hang of this commentary. Have to look in one direction to see the beach and then the other to see the monitor. Cliffs here are estimated 5 meters high. There's a 5 to 10 meter wide beach. And occasional transverse bars here in the lower intertidal. Sand in the lower intertidal. back shore. And a 5 to 8 meter high cliff, sand and gravel backing that. We're now coming around to the point, there's a peat at the top of the cliff, and some massive ice. There's a large retrogressive thaw failure just around the point there. And then fringing a spit beach development into the bay beyond that. Panning across to the back of the bay here, and now dropping to the outer coast in the foreground. Narrow promontory, partial barrier extending out across the entrance from the toward the southwest. And a small supertidal marsh component in these little embayments and cliffs. Sand and gravel cliff here, up to 10 meters high. Boulders and cobbles on the back shore. Sand, small pebble fraction in the foreshore. Massive ice failure back there. Stabilized retrogressive thaw failure here. Cliffs in the foreground, sand and gravel up to 10 meters high. Some boulder cobble material at the base of the cliffs. And now we're swimming around across the mouth of another breached lake system here. Wide intertidal muddy sand inside the lake, back of the barrier. Sand and some gravel in the barrier back shore. Retrogressive thaw failure there with ice in the head wall. And a stabilized one beyond that. Stabilized, gullied, gravel in the lower foreshore and the intertidal here. Peat occasionally showing up in the top of the cliffs, sand and gravel for the most part of the cliffs, and occasional cobble boulder material in the beach, and that extends into the foreshore where the beach is narrow. Sandy swash bar on the intertidal here, sand behind that, and sandy gravel on the back shore. A narrow sandy gravel beach, peak ice and sand and gravel on the cliffs up to 3 meters high, and then rising here to closer to 10 meters, a rough estimate. Wide intertidal zone here, up to 10 meters in width. And sands in the subtidal. Multiple bar system in the subtidal there. And picking up at the head of the bay, a small barrier with lagoon behind. Pebbly sand in the crest. Channel into a large lake system in the back with cliffs and another complex prograded barrier system at the point. Beach material is sand and gravel, gravel leg, foreshore and on the crest of the barrier. A minor algal component and some herbaceous growth in the flood tidal delta complex, very little ebb delta development. Narrow beach, up to 8 meters wide. Occasional swash bars. Picking one up here with the cliff of estimated 5 meters sand and gravel in the back shore. I see some whales here. Yeah. Picking up some ice at the top of the cliff here. Cobble boulder material at the point at the base of the cliff. Beluga whales in the water in front of the beach here. Picking up occasional accumulations of cobble boulder at the base of the cliffs. The beach here is 5 meters wide, sand in the lower intertidal, sand and gravel in the back shore. Three-meter cliff here, sand and gravel back shore. Some fines and sand and small gravel component in the foreshore. Time is 11:20. The lighting is difficult, but there appear to be multiple bars in the subtitle. Occasional boulder and cobble material in the back shore. Silty sand and gravel in the lower foreshore. Cliffs estimated 5 meters in height. Feet at the top of the cliff. Coming up now to a zone of higher cliffs. Rising to estimated 10 meters. Old failures, retrogressive failures, gullies. Still supplying some material to the beach. Some evidence of multiple bars in the subtitle. We check from the vertical photography. And panning across the top of Null Breach Lake here. Stand at the point. The camera now. Gravel sand spit complex. Wide intertidal, 20 meters, 20, 30 meters with transverse bars and sands in the lake back. 5 to 8 meter cliffs, sand and gravel in the foreground. Sandy lower foreshore, sand and gravel, some cobble component in the back shore. And lots of massive ice in the headwall of this retrogressive failure. Some mud flow transport of sands, muds and gravels to the beach. Sandy beach, some occasional gravel showing up in the back shore. And the same all along here. Southeast side, sands and gravels in the back shore on the east side. Some some herbaceous and algal growth in the thin supertidal marsh in the back behind the lagoon. And as we come around the front here, the cliff source, sands and gravels in those cliffs, wide swash bar complex in the lower foreshore and sands, and sand and gravel in the back shore. Less pines in the cliffs here, sands, some gravel in the lower foreshore, and again into sandy lower foreshore, occasional small gravel fraction in the back shore. This is largely sands here, very little gravel, just patches picked up in places where these mud flows have come out onto the beach and then been truncated. Wide sandy beach here, backed by low peak cliffs and some wind reworking of sand into the front of the cliffs. Large boulder in the subtidal here. More peat, some ice in the peat there. Occasional boulders, cobbles, but primarily this is all sand here. Wide swash bar complexes and an estimated 10 meter wide intertidal zone narrowing here to a narrow fringe of 3 meters. Estimated 2 to 3 meter backshore beach. Lots of sands in the backshore here. Some wind reworking. Lots of sand in the cliff in the back. The cliff is estimated 10 to 12 meters high. And then we're coming up here to a beach lake complex, a tidal inlet with a sandy bar system and supertidal, some intertidal marsh in the back. These cliffs have a very high sand content. Very little gravel on the beach. The beach is estimated 5 meters wide. Cliffs estimated 10 meters high. Multiple bar system in the subtidal. Occasional cobble material is scattered along the beach. Relatively little thermokarst activity here, largely gullying. A lot of sand transport to the back shore of the beach. Just the occasional patch of cobble boulder material, very little pebble-sized material on the beach here. It's largely a sand beach, 5 meters in width, low angle, and very faint evidence of 1, 2, 3, 4 bars in the subtidal. Cliffs estimated 8 meters high, sandy beach. 5 meters, widening occasionally to 10 or 12, perhaps 15 meters in width. Mostly sands in the cliffs in the back. pebble cobble material at the base of the cliffs. In the back here, where the just before we come to the lake. But for the most part, the beach here is all sand. Occasional cut at the base of the cliffs, and wind reworking sand into a ramp at the base. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four bars faintly visible in the subtitle. All sands here in the beach. And coming up to a little foreland, estimated 80 meters in width, perhaps 100 meters. And 10 to 15 meter cliff, perhaps up to 20 meters in the back shore. Onto that little foreland now, and then coming up onto the cliff source in the foreground. Sands and gravels in the cliff. Very little gravel in the beach. Minor swash bar developed in the lower foreshore. Wide gully apron at the base of the cliffs. Sand and gravel in the cliffs. Largely sand in the apron, been partially reworked by wind. Wide back shore and foreshore, sands with some gravel component. We come along here, we pick up a little bit of cobble material at the base of the cliffs. For the most part, the beach is sand here. There is a wide bar in the subtidal. And the cliffs are estimated 10 to 15 meters high. Again, picking up boulder and some cobble-sized material, some boulder material in the back shore. But for the most part, the beach is looks like a medium fine sand. 1, 2, 3, 4 multiple bars in the subtitle. Excuse me here. Complex multiple bar system in the subtitle. Sand in the lower intertidal, sand in the upper intertidal in the back shore, some gravel in the back shore, but primarily sand still. Lower cliffs, estimated 8 meters high. Still largely sands in the cliffs, some reworking by wind in the back shore. 1, 2, 3, perhaps 4 subtidal bars. Narrow beach, estimated 10 meters wide at the widest. And the cliffs are estimated 10 to 15 meters high. Perhaps reaching up to 20 meters in some places. Stratified sands and gravels. Appears to be relatively little massive ice in the cliffs in this area. And still we're getting some magnificent bars in the subtitle, but they're not really showing up in the video at all. Largely sand in the cliffs, a lot of wind reworking at the base of the cliffs. And the subtitle bar complex is transverse as we come around the point here. Oriented, estimated southeast-northwest. And you're seeing a little bit of the bar complex in the foreground there. For the most part, the subtitle bars are not showing up in the video. Sand in the lower intertidal, sand in the upper intertidal, some gravel with the sand, but very little gravel on the hull. That gravel is exclusively in the back shore. As you can tell. Some gullying back into material that may have ice in it. Sands and gravels, some mud probably in the cliffs here. 1, 2 bars visible in the subtitle. Very occasional cobble or boulder material in the foreshore and back shore. Beaches here, still largely sands. Minor gravel in the back shore. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 subtidal bars. Point coming up in the picture now. Sand and gravel cliffs in the back shore. Low cut at the base of the cliffs. Estimated 8 to 10 meter wide beach. Magnificent subtidal bars here, really not showing up in the video. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bars parallel to shore. Occasional transverse components. And a little wider intertidal of the outlet from that gully there. Cliffs are lower, estimated 5 meters maximum height here. Still a complex subtidal bar system. Sand in the lower intertidal of the beach, some gravel back shore at the base of the cliffs. Time is 11:38. Wider intertidal here. Evidently very low sloping subtidal bench with these complex multiple bars features in the subtidal. And here we have peat and sand gravel and cliffs in the back shore. Minor gravel in the back shore on the beach, sand and peat class in the lower intertidal. Multiple bar system in the subtidal. The lower intertidal and subtidal are all sand. At 65 statute miles per hour. And with those lakes in the back foreshore, we have still sand, some peak glass. Largely sands, minor gravels, and peat cliffs here. Cliffs are estimated 5 to 8 meters high. The beach estimated 8 to 10 meters wide. Bars in the subtidal transverse at this point, 45 degrees to the shore, oriented southeast northwest. Largely sand in the beach here. Occasional aprons where gullies are coming out of the cliffs. Minor wind reworking of the back shore sands. Minor gravel in the back shore, sand in the lower intertidal and in the subtidal. And some wind reworking of sand up the gullies onto the cliff top. Little barrier complex, the little barrier, I should say, at the mouth of that valley and the lake in it. 1, 2, 3, 4 bars in the subtidal. Still sands in the beach. Narrow beach fronting a estimated 10 meter high cliff here. Sands and gravels at the cliff, some muds. Peat across the top, peat class in the back shore. Minor gravel in the back shore, but primarily sand on the beach. Low slope to the beach. Wide subtidal platform. Largely sands, wind apron at the base of the cliffs, 1, 2, 3, subtidal bar, transits visible. Narrow beach along the base of the cliffs here still. Peat class, very little gravel. Cliffs rising to 8 to 10 meters high. And we're coming up to a little low point here. Small lagoon and wide intertidal flats, muddy sands. And then back to a narrower intertidal and beach fringing the base of these cliffs that are estimated at 8 to 10 meters high, sands and gravels. But primarily sand in the beach, very little gravel, if any, in the beach. Still bars visible in the subtidal. But very faintly, it's difficult to see what they're like here. And largely sands, minor gravel, mud, peat, and cliffs here, estimated 15 to 20 meters high. The only wind reworking of sands in the back shore occasionally cuts the base of the cliff elsewhere. The beach is all sand here, very minor gravel component in the back shore. Time is 11:42, proceeding east along the north shore of Liverpool Bay, gate number 2. Count 230. Beach here is estimated at 10 to, in some cases, 15 meters wide. Occasional wide runoff aprons, little fans, sands largely, at the back of the beach. Been truncated and in some cases reworked by wind. Minor gravel component in the back of the beach. And where we pick up this little barrier here, we have some gravel on the back shore at the left side of the valley. But primarily we're looking at sands. Beginning to pick up occasional driftwood in the back shore here now. Wind reworking of sands there into that gully. Wide wind apron of sands in the back shore. Sandy beach in the foreshore. And again, another little barrier complex at this lake. Very little gravel visible, some driftwood now. Swash bar complex. Minor gravel and driftwood in the back shore. Reworking it. Sand in the back shore, sandy foreshore. Minor gravel component in the foreshore here. We are picking up some gravel in the foreshore here now. Old, partially stabilized failure, still partially active, largely gully reworking in there now. Some transported material down through those beaches to the back shore. Picking up more muds, minor slumping at the face of the cliffs. It's cut by waves. Gravel in the back shore, showing that white there, and sand, minor gravel in the lower intertidal. Picking up more gravel along the back of the beach here. Cliffs are estimated 15 to 20, about 25 meters high. Largely sand visible in the cliffs. Gravel in the back shore, minor gravel and sand in the lower intertidal. Picking up much more gravel here. Two, possibly three parallel bars in the subtidal. Sand, minor gravel in the intertidal. Gravel showing up white in places in the back shore at the base of the cliffs. Sand and gravel, some mud, and organic cliffs. One, two, three bars visible in the subtidal here. Inner bars estimated 100 meters off the beach. Gravel and sand in the beach foreshore. Gravel, minor sand in the back shore. Sand reworked by wind in the back shore at the base of the cliffs. Those appear to be largely sand, but there must be some gravel in them as well. We're coming up here to another area of large old failures, still partially active in the cliffs. They've moved back to the transport out of those failures, now largely by water runoff, rain runoff, presumably by snow melt in spring. Minor gravel at the back of the beach where these aphids have been truncated. Still largely sand in the beach foreshore, but there may be some gravel in there. It's a little difficult to see. Sand, minor gravel in the beach back shore. Little runoff bands truncated by waves in the back shore. There's largely sands in these bands. Some gravel on the surface of the bands. Minor gravel in the beach. Cliffs here are estimated 10 meters high. The beach is estimated 10 meters wide. 1, 2, 3 bars in the subtidal. And we're coming up to a promontory here with a wider beach. Before that, we see these failures with sediment being transported from the headwalls down to fans at the back of the beach. These have been truncated by waves. Largely sands, minor gravel, some driftwood. Here we have this wide foreland, estimated 100, 120 meters wide. Sand in the back shore. Sand and gravel in the transport, sand in the lower foreshore. Large sands here again, and as we come up, updrift of that, we have 1, 2, 3, possibly 4 bars in the subtidal. Narrow beach, cliff estimated 8 to 10 meters, perhaps up to 15 meters high. Sand and gravel, some mud, some ice. And peat along the top. Narrow sandy beach, minor gravel, some peat clasts. Still some bars faintly visible in the subtidal. Largely sands, minor gravel in the beach. Beach is estimated 30 meters wide here. Some wind reworking of sands at the base of the cliffs. The cliffs are largely peats with presumably some ice in them here. It's a little difficult to see. There's not much gravel in the back shore. Minor gravel in the back shore. Largely sands here. Little swash bars in the intertidal, the foreshore. Sands in the back shore. wider beach and dried pond in the back, wind reworking sands at the base of the cliff, some driftwood, very minor gravel in the foreshore. Angel gravel showing up at the base of the cliffs here with the peak blasts. Squash bar in the tidal. 1, 2, 3 subtidal bars, maybe showing up in the video a little bit now. Sand, gravel, ice, some mud, peat, and cliffs. The cliffs are estimated 8 meters high. Minor gravel showing up in the back of the cliffs here now. Count is 353. Time is 11:49, 24th of July, North Shore, Liverpool Bay. We are approaching just south of Johnson Bay here now. The mouth of Liverpool Bay. 1, 2, 3, 4 bar crests in the subtidal. Minor gravel, largely sand in the beach. Low cliff, estimated 8 meters high. Some massive ice showing up in that cliff there now. Largely sand and gravel. We're coming around the point toward, looking back now, southwest, along the north shore of Liverpool Bay. And we have ice in these cliffs, sand and gravel. Very narrow, fringing beach, largely sands. And we pan around now to the right, to the mouth of Johnson Bay. Cusped foreland to the west side. And a recurved spit with a wide intertidal sands, largely. Minor gravel, gravel in the crest of the spit, sand in the lower intertidal. At the northeast side of the mouth of Johnson Bay. And along to the north of Johnson Bay. Cliffs here are estimated 8 meters high. Occasional peat and ice in the cliffs, largely sand and gravel. Very narrow fringing beach in some places. Very little gravel visible. Transverse bar complex here at 45 degrees to shore. Some evidence of alignment in features onshore parallel to those. Here we have very narrow fringing beach. Minor gravel at the back shore. Sand and gravel cliffs estimated 5 meters high in the back shore. Three bars in the subtitle. Sands and gravels, largely sands, wind reworking of sands in the back shore. The base of the cliffs, estimated 3 to 5 meters high. And some windblown dune development here. First dunes that we've really seen well developed, partially stabilized by vegetation. Complex bars in the subtitle. Sand, minor gravel, driftwood in the beach, concentrated on the high tide mark. I should say the swash limit mark. And organics concentrated on the high tide mark. 1, 2, 3 bars in the subtitle. Sand, very minor gravel, if any at all. Deep in the back shore. Low cliffs, 2 to 3 meters high, sands largely. Narrow fringing beach of sand. And some peak blasts foreshore. Subtidal, 1, 2, 3 bars, sands. We have some windblown sand on the top of the cliffs here, including minor dune development. And then back into low cliff, estimated 4 meters high, sand and gravel. Largely sands, very little gravel if any. Count is 423. And time is 11:53. Still largely sands, very little gravel, if any, in the beach. Low angle beach, up to 10 to 15 meters wide at the point there. And we're picking up a lot of wind reworked sand on the top of the cliffs here now. Cliffs are 2 meters, perhaps up to 3, in some cases now up to 5 meters high. Largely sands, very little ice, very little gravel. Perhaps minor gravel at the base of the cliff. There can be drift in there. A lot of wind reworking of sand on the top of cliffs and initiation of dune development here. And now we're picking up a backshore relief. It's been overwash transport into these ponds, some supertidal marsh. Some heat in the foreshore on the foreground. Sand, minor gravel, a lot of driftwood. Complex partial transfer deposits here with what appear to be sharp slip faces oriented in towards the northwest. Dune development, well-developed dunes, with some ditching cliff development in front of the dunes. All sands here with some peak, very little evidence of gravel at all. Multiple bar system in the foreshore. Cliffs here are estimated maximum 5 meters high, largely sands. The beach is 10 meters in width. Multiple bar system with partially transverse to the shore and foreshore. New development back shore. It's 11:59, 24th of July. Yeah. hard sandy shelf with evidence of the tidal channel estimated 100, 150 meters wide running in through. And across the back of the lake here, and after we pick up the point at the other side of the lake here, the sands, extensive overwash, some wind reworking of sands, and peat in the foreshore here. Sandy beach, peat extending all the way to the water's edge in places. The cut in the peat here is estimated 1 meter in width, in height rather. The beach is estimated 3 to 4 meters width at its widest. Coming into the picture now. And we have a little washbar spit or barrier here with flooded ice wedge polygon super tidal flats in the background as we swing into this breached lake heading toward the west. You swing right around there, it's getting bright and bright. Super tidal flats, flooded ice wedge polygons all around the head of this breached lake. Occasional patches of sandy beach. For the most part, the shore is devoid of beach. Peat comes right to the shoreline in places. Beach are very much like Chaos Island in the Babbage Delta here. Appears to be transgressed ice wedge polygon, low relief terrain. Along the north side of the lake, as we head out toward the outer coast here again, we have a sandy beach, sandy fringing beach along the front of this low terrain. Occasional peat cliff, perhaps really it's just a cut in some poorly developed, partially stabilized sand dunes. And then this wide overwashed sand flat. Sand dunes beyond that. And peat in the lower intertidal, right at the water's edge. A lot of wind activity in the sand here. Driftwood all along the storm surge limit. And as we come around to the outer coast here, we're picking up a low cliff, 3 to 4 meters high. Appears to be mostly sand. The narrow beach is all sand, no gravel visible at all. And we've got more sand dunes here. Some cut at the front of the fore dune. Sand dunes extending in over the back shore terrain. Low cliffs, mostly sand, hidden in shadow as we come around into the lake again. We're entering another breached lake embayment here, and part way into the lake view now is a little recurve spit of sand. Swinging around again, low cliff, 2, perhaps 3 meters high at the maximum. Top of sand dunes in some places. Beach wider there in front of the sand dunes in the picture now. Then we come back into cliffs. Low cliffs, 2 meters, perhaps 3 meters at the maximum. Narrow fringing beach. Bars in the subtidal. Beach is entirely sand. Cliffs are sand with a thin Holocene peak cover. And we're coming around to the mouth of another breached lake. that's the front of that. Sandy beach, variable width, sandbars and subtidal, complex power pattern. Cliffs appear to be exclusively sand here. We're seeing nothing but sand in the beach. Beach is 1.5 to 4 meters wide, except at discontinuities in the shoreline, such as this, where we get wide, 50, 60 meter wide flats, backed by sand dunes. Windblown sand apron at the base of the cliff, and dunes developed on top of the cliff. And then around into sand cliff again, four meters high, next to no beach at the base. Combination of low cliffs and sand dunes developed on top of the cliffs or on the low terrain in depressions between higher ground. And if we come out to the point here, we're picking up some peat. I guess it's off the cliff face, extending all the way into the lower foreshore. In the distance there, we have another beach lake, wide sand flat at the point. And we're going to cut across the entrance to this cliff, to this lake. Material here is all sands. Places there's no beach at all. Elsewhere, as here, we have a little cuspate foreland. Developed as a recurved spit that's infilled behind. Sand cliff, no beach. Estimated 3 meters high. Between Char Point and Cape Dalhousie, east end of the Tuck Peninsula, heading north toward Cape Dalhousie. Time is 14:14, 24th of July, 1984. Here appears to be almost exclusively sand. An area of marine transgression with large embayments caused by the breaching of shallow lakes. Low relief terrain in backshore, ice wedge polygons. Here in the foreground we have overwash and wind transport of sand onto the slow relief terrain in the back shore with sand dunes developed, moving into an area of low cliffs, 2 to 3 meters high. Beach narrows to a maximum 1 meter in places. Some ice where the ice wedges are intersected by the coast, but it's largely low ice content sands. And we're coming around into the entrance to one of these breach lakes. Sand beach. Overwash onto ice wedge polygon terrain in the background. Driftwood deposited at the storm surge limit. All sands here. Some of the ice wedge polygon features extending all the way to the water's edge and into the subtidal. Picking up sand cliffs again, 3 meters high. Narrow beach to maximum 3 meters at the base of the cliffs. Some sand blown up under the top of the cliffs. Thin Holocene peat on top of the cliff. Minor sand dune development here. This lake, some peat extending into the lower foreshore. Narrow sand. sand cliffs. And again, we move into an area of low peat terrain, peat extending into the water, and some sand dune development on top. We're looking here across at some of the inland lakes, losing the shore as we make a sharp turn to the right to head out toward the outer coast. We're going to pick up a large spit, large-ish spit, at the north side of the mouth of this daemon. So, to be coming into the picture now, sand, and some peat clasts. Sand and organics in this spit feature, with some small sand dune development at the proximal end at the point. We're heading north now along the outer shore, coming into an area of low cliffs, narrow fringing beach, narrows to zero in some places. A lot of organic to the cliffs here. Cliffs estimated 2.5 meters, maximum 3 meters high. And as we come toward the head of this little embayment, we pick up a wider sand beach at the base of the cliffs. Foreshore material here is all entirely sand. The beach narrows to zero in some places. Here in the right area in the foreground is peat extending down into the water with some minor windblown sand on top. Peat's at the water's edge here in places. Some sand dune development in the back shore. Back to an area of low cliffs. Beach in some places here is entirely organic material at the base of the cliffs. Elsewhere, fine sands. Combination of sands and reworked peat. Low cliff, 1 meter high, and then we lose the cliff altogether as we come out to the point here. Peat in the lower end of tidal, extensive washover sands, and driftwood at the back shore and in over the low-lying back shore terrain. Pick up sand at the water's edge again now as we come into this area of low cliffs, 2 meters, 2 to 3 meters, 3 meters high, all sands and organics. The beach is entirely sand, up to 3 meters wide. Cliffs estimated at this point here in the picture now, 4 meters high, the maximum. And we have a large beach accumulation at the point at the south side of the entrance to this breach lake system again. Cut across the mouth of this lake. Features of marine transgression across this